And the last question. You are in Israel at the election day, and I hear that you will come soon, probably to another election day. Now, I attended your speech there, and you concluded your speech with something profoundly important. You said, Hashem oz le'amo iten, and then you said that we, as the Jewish people in the Jewish state, must have oz, which is power. We cannot rely on no one to save us.
That's
So,
right.
which is of course relates to the Pollard case. Now, can you please elaborate what exactly did you mean, and how does this wisdom might change the way that the government or the Israeli government need to work with the new president or the new administration?
Elie Wiesel once said that the lesson for him of the Shoah is always believe the threats of your enemies before you believe the promises of your friends. Israel can never rely on the United States for its continued ability to defend itself. It has to maintain close relations with the United States. The United States is the most important ally, but Israel has to prepare for a potential time when AOC and others may take over the Democratic Party. Look, it came close. If some of the people who ran for the Democratic nomination, Bernie Sanders or others, had won, Israel's relationship with the United States would be severely damaged. It was damaged under some Republicans as well, George H.W. Bush and Dwight Eisenhower. So Israel has to develop an ability, and it has developed an ability to defend itself, and it must be able to stand alone. And the most striking example is Israel may, hopefully not, but may have to destroy the Iranian nuclear capacity by itself. It may have to do that. Hopefully, it would have the help of the United States. Hopefully, Iran would not move toward developing nuclear weapons, but I believe it probably will. And unless it believes that Israel will, by itself or with the help of the United States, prevent Iran from becoming a nuclear armed enemy, Israel would face an existential crisis. So, Hashem oz le'amo yitein is a very important lesson. The history of the Holocaust is a history that Jews get peace only through strength. Jews don't get peace through friendship or through mercy or through compassion. Mahatma Gandhi, the great Indian, didn't support the Jews during the Holocaust. Many other people didn't support the Jews during the Holocaust. Many in Britain didn't support the Jews during the Holocaust. Churchill did. Franklin Delano Roosevelt didn't do enough to allow Jews to come into the United States. So Jews and the nation state of the Jewish people have to be prepared to defend itself. That's the lesson of the Shoah. That's the lesson of Israel's existence from the very beginning. It fought its war of independence alone without the help of the United States. It basically fought the 67 war alone. Hopefully, the alliance between Israel and the United States will continue, but Israel has to be prepared to go to it alone and to always defend its existence, its ability to thrive, by itself. And it is doing so. It's doing a great job militarily, economically, scientifically, diplomatically. And so no country in history has done as well in the first 72 years of its existence as Israel has done, and may it go from strength to strength.
Professor Allen, thank you so much. Like always, it was an eye-opening interview. Thank you so much for your time and for everything that you do for free speech, for the liberal movement in the US, and of course for Israel. Many, many, many thanks.
Thank you. Thank you for your great questions. It was an honor for me to be on your show.